In this video, we'll try to understand how to draw shear force diagram and bending moment diagram in case of cantilever beam carrying uniformly varying load. The arrangement of the cantilever beam is as shown over here. It carries a uniformly varying load from W kN per meter at free end up to zero at the fixed end. The span length is L. Now we'll consider any section XX at a distance X from the free end. So total span length is L and this distance is X. So therefore this remaining distance is L minus X. Now we have to find out the shear force at any section XX. Now from the similarity of the triangle, so we'll first consider this smaller triangle, that is this particular triangle, and then we'll consider this larger triangle. So in this particular smaller triangle, the height is y and the base is L minus x. So y upon L minus x is equal to w is the height of this larger triangle divided by base is L. So we'll get the value of y, that is w upon L multiplied by this L minus x. Or if you multiply by this w by L inside the bracket, so w by L into L, so L will get cancelled off, so it is only w, and w by L into x, so that is w minus w by L x. So we can use either this value or this value for the further simplification. Now the shear force at this particular section will be consisting of two parts. So as you can see over here, this will be the triangular distribution or uniformly varying load, and the another part of this particular will be the uniformly distributed load. So first we'll concentrate on this particular triangular distribution, starting from this end up to this end, or you can say that from this end up to this end. Now the uniformly varying load, it is given by 1/2 base into height. So the base of this particular triangle is x and its height is w minus y. So it is 1/2 x into w minus y. Now substitute the value of y that just now we have calculated. It is w minus w by L x. Take negative sign inside. So w minus w. This minus minus will become plus. So this w will get cancelled out. So it is 1/2 x into w by L x. That is nothing but w upon 2L x into x. That is x square. So this is the load due to the uniformly varying load, correct, at any section XX. Now we have to consider this bottom part, which is nothing but the uniformly distributed load. So we know that it is the rectangular distribution having the width of X and height is Y. So it is only X into Y. So area of this rectangle is X into Y. Substitute the value of Y. So suppose we take this expression. So X into W by L into L minus X. Now we have just multiplied by this x inside the bracket. So x into L, that is Lx, and x into x, that is x square. So we can say that shear force at any section xx is the two loads F1 and F2 which are there. Now as they are acting in the downward direction, now we have attached this negative sign over here. So minus F1 and this is minus F2. So minus W upon 2L x square, that is the value of F1, and minus W upon L, Lx minus X square. So this is the shear, general shear stress equation for any distance X from the free end. Now we have to draw the shear force diagram. The conventions as usual, upward forces, they are considered as positive and downward forces, they are considered as negative. So shear force at any section XX is given by this particular relation, which just now we have derived. Now at point A, distance A is measured from this, distance X is measured from this particular point A. So at point A, X is 0. So we can substitute X is equal to 0 over here. So all the terms will become 0. So we can say that shear force at A will be 0. For shear force at B, we have to substitute in place of X, L. So it is minus W upon 2L into L square. Again, in place of X, we have substituted L. So it is L square minus L square, that is 0. So this second term will get cancelled up. Here, L square and L, one L will get cancelled up. So it is only minus 1 upon 2 WL kilonewton. So we'll draw now the shear force diagram. So at point A it is 0 and at point B it is minus 1 by 2 W into L. Now the shear force goes on increasing, so therefore this type of the curve will be achieved and it is a second degree curve. Now we have to draw the bending moment diagram. Again, we know that for this particular rectangular arrangement, the force will convert this uniformly distributed load into a point load acting at the center of this length, that is x by 2. So base is x and half of that is x by 2. So we are considering this bottom part where uniformly distributed load of F2 is acting. Then F1 is the load for this particular triangular distribution and it will be acting at the centroid of this triangular lamina. So centroid lies at a distance of 2/3 of the base, so 2 by 3 of the base, base is x from the apex. So this is the apex of the triangular lamina. So we have converted this upper triangular distribution or upper uniformly varying load into a point load acting at the centroid of the triangular section, that is 2 by 3x from the apex. Similarly, we have converted this uniformly distributed load into a point load of F2 acting at the center of the rectangular distribution. So center of the rectangular distribution is x by 2, whereas centroid of the triangular lamina is at a distance of 2 by 3x from the apex. So both this particular, now we have to take the moment about this section xx, and both these particular forces, they will produce anti-clockwise moment. So for example, we'll start with F1. This F1 will produce the anti-clockwise moment about this. So F1 into 2 by 3x, and as it is anti-clockwise, it is taken as negative. Similarly, this F2, it will also produce anti-clockwise moment. So minus F2 into x by 2. Substitute the value of F1. F1 is W by 2L x square, 2 by 3x as it is. Substitute the value of F2, it is W by L, Lx minus x square, and this x by 2 as it is. So we can cancel out these two from the numerator as well as from the denominator. So it is W upon 3L x square into x, that is x cube, minus W upon L, Lx minus x square into x by 2. So this is the general expression for the bending moment. So we have written that particular general expression over here. The bending moment diagram conventions are clockwise positive and anti-clockwise negative. Now we know that at point A, x is equal to 0. So if you substitute x is equal to 0, the entire term will be 0. At point B, we will substitute x is equal to L. So in place of x, it is L cube. Over here, it is L square minus L square. So that is 0. So this second term will get cancelled out. Now cancel out this one L cube and out of this one L cube and L term. So it will be minus W by 3 L square kilonewton meter. Using these values, we can draw the bending moment diagram over here. So it is a 3 degree parabolic, negative parabolic curve that we obtain. So in this way, we can draw shear force and bending moment diagram in case of cantilever beam carrying uniformly varying load. Thank you very much for watching.